About friends, so as I told you in my previous video, that in this video we shall be discussing about the types of the chemical bonds, and more special we shall be dealing with the covalent bonds. So let us first start by defining the chemical bond. A chemical bond is the force of attraction between the two atoms to form a molecule or a compound. So simply, chemical bond is the force of attraction holding together two or more atoms. That's why in my previous video I told you that a chemical bond is like a glue which holds together atoms. So now we have three types of chemical bonds, which are covalent, and we have electrovalent, sometimes called ionic, and then we have metallic. So covalent, electrovalent, and metallic. Some of the literatures you will visit and you will find another additional type of the chemical bond, which is called the hydrogen bond. So we shall discuss this. Just don't worry. We shall discuss this later in the next lectures. So here in these notes, they are mentioned only three: covalent, electrovalent, and metallic. But even hydrogen bond will be discussed. So let us directly start with the covalent bonding. Covalent bonding. So what is covalent bond? What is a covalent bond? Covalent bond is the type of chemical bond which occur due to sharing of electrons between two atoms. As I told you before, that we have three methods of gaining stability of an atom, which are sharing of an electron, losing of electrons, and gaining of electrons. So when an atom loses or gains an electron, it forms the ionic or electrovalent bond. But when an atom shares an electron, it forms covalent bond, shares an electron with another nonmetal. One nonmetal shares electrons with another nonmetal, they form the covalent bonds. So now, here in the covalent bonds, which are formed by the sharing of electrons between two atoms, we have different types of the covalent bonds. According to that, sharing of electrons is formed between elements of which type. So now let's go direct to discuss about the types of the covalent bonds which can be found, which can be formed by different types of the element. So in the types of the covalent bonds, we have three types of the covalent bonds. The first we call it is the non-polar covalent bond or a normal covalent bond. And then we have polar covalent bond. And then from there, we have dirty covalent bond, or it is sometimes called as the coordinate bond. So now, let's first discuss about the non-polar, and then we shall go to discuss polar, and later we shall go to discuss about the dirty. So, non-polar covalent bond. So in the non-polar covalent bond, one thing you should note is that the sharing of electron is done between the two electrons having the same electronegativity. What is electronegativity now? Electronegativity is the ability of an electron to attract electrons towards itself. So as we know that the nucleus is positively charged, as we discussed in the atomic structure, and we know that the electrons, they are negatively charged. The nucleus is positively charged due to the protons, and the electrons, they are negatively charged. So always electrons, they are attracted towards the nucleus. The electrons within an atom are attracted towards the nucleus. And even the electrons from outside the atom, they can be attracted towards the nucleus. So the ability of an electron to attract, or the ability of an atom, I mean, sorry, the ability of an atom to attract electrons towards itself is what we call electronegativity. So saying maybe we have two chlorine atoms, or saying maybe we have two fluorine atoms. The two chlorine atoms, they have the same ability of attracting electrons towards themselves. That is because of the distance between the nucleus and the outermost shell, and the number of electrons in that chlorine atoms. So when we shall go to study in inorganic chemistry, we shall go to see more about the factors affecting the electronegativity of an atom. And one among those factors is the atomic number, and then is the radius of an atom, or atomic size of an atom. If the atomic size of an atom, increases, the electronegativity of an atom decreases. That is because if the distance between the nucleus and the outermost shell increases, the ability of the nucleus to attract the out electrons or the electrons from another atom to itself becomes very small. So that's all about electronegativity, ability of an atom to attract electrons towards itself. So here we can say polar covalent bond is the type of bond which is formed when bond electrons are shared equally or are shared between two electrons with the same electronegativity. So it occurs between atoms which have the same electronegativity, atoms of the same element. So for example, let's say, taking an example, you are joining two fluorines. So as you know, in the periodic table, fluorine is the group 7 element. So if you are starting our known song, Hello Helena Lile Bebelo, so you can start Hello Helena Lile Bebelo Bora Chinjana Ondoa Figo. So this will be first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. So fluorine is the ninth element. So the electronic configuration of fluorine, it will be as the 1s2, and then 2s2, and then 2p. This is 4, this is 2p5. This is an electronic configuration of fluorine. So this is according to advanced level. But in chemical bonding, we sometimes, in this part, we sometimes simply use that of the O level. So say the electronic configuration of the fluorine, it is 2, then it is 2, 7. So drawing this electronic configuration, we found that we have two electrons here, and then we have 7 electrons, say these are two here, and then these are two, and here we have. So we have 7 electrons in the outermost shell of the fluorine atom. Now from here we can say that if fluorine combines with another fluorine, say it combines with another fluorine which has 7 electrons in the outermost shell, what will be found here is that it will have the structure seen like this. It will be observed like this. So here, these two electrons have been shared between two fluorines. And as you can see here, the one electron from fluorine here is shared with one electron from fluorine here to form this compound. So from here now, the two electrons which are fluorine have the same ability of attracting electrons towards themselves or towards the nucleus. So because the two fluorines have the same ability for attracting electrons towards their nucleus, that is what we can call the normal covalent bond or the polar covalent bond. So from here now, we can say that if these fluorines, we can draw them as like this. The ability of this fluorine to attract electron towards itself And the ability of this fluorine to attract electron towards itself, they are equal. So here we can draw like this. These two dots, if you can look them, they are at the center of that line, indicating that this fluorine attracts electrons equally with another fluorine. So a third thing to note here is that when we shall going to discuss about the non-polar covalent, these are non-polar covalent bond. When we shall going to discuss about the polar covalent bond, where the polarity comes from, because we shall go to discuss after this. And I want you to understand this concept even before we are going there. So where the polarity comes from? The polarity starts when the sharing of electron is done between the two electrons having different electronegativity. So different electronegativity means that their ability to attract electrons towards themselves is different. So saying maybe you are joining two electrons, and one electron, I mean you are joining two atoms, and one atom have the higher ability of attracting electron towards itself compared to another atom. So that atom which will have the higher ability of attracting electrons towards itself, it will pull the electrons. Pulling the electrons towards itself will cause another element to become slightly positively charged, and that element or that atom will become slightly positively charged. So here we can say that note a molecule in which bond electrons are shared equally is called a nonpolar molecule. So nonpolar molecule, they have zero dipole moment. So don't worry about the concept of dipole moment, and don't worry that how can I understand about the dipole moment? Don't worry. So you shall understand it later. And for this lecture, I will end here, and let's meet in the next lecture. Subscribe my channel, and let's meet in the next lecture where we shall discuss about the polar covalent bonds. And I hope you will enjoy the lecture. Subscribe my channel, join my Telegram group for more updates and the notes for this topic which I am teaching. Thank you.